6, a helping hand with your land.
Neil from Messex here to give you some tips on how to maximize the trade-in values for your equipment. Got 7 different recommendations I can give to you. Recommendations when you're buying a new piece, or ownership tips to make sure when you go to sell that machine down the road that you get as much money for it as possible. So come along with me here today, have a quick conversation, and make sure that we keep as much of that money as possible in your pocket. The very first tip I can give you is to buy the right kind of equipment. If you're thinking that you're going to be turning something over in the future, buying a machine that's desirable on the secondary market is really important. And one of the ways that you can do that is sticking to the mainline manufacturers that people are going to recommend and trust, especially when they go to buy a used one. Sticking to companies like Case, New Holland, Kubota, and Deere, you know, those guys, people trust their products in the marketplace, and so they have a confidence in those brands that years down the road, they're going to be okay supporting those used machines as they age. So avoiding kind of that second tier of suppliers that are out there on the market, you're going to retain a lot more of that value when you go to sell the machine. Another thing that really helps is paying attention to the current model number that a manufacturer is making. If you're buying something that's not the current production model, or you buy a model and it's very soon replaced by a new one, that automatically causes a hit on the secondary market. Whenever you have a used piece of equipment that is still the current model that's being sold today, people are always willing to pay a lot more for it because it's got all the same latest features and updates and improvements that a manufacturer is selling in their brand new products today. They're not, say, lacking something that a new machine is going to have. So trying to avoid owning that piece of equipment that's just about to go obsolete, or buying last year's model if you're planning on selling the machine in the not too distant future, is going to help retain the value in that piece of equipment. I'd say you probably take about a 10% hit or so when those models roll over. And remember, they don't make equipment in model years. There is no such thing as a 2018, 2019, 2020. Our models don't work that way. Manufacturers tend to come out with a piece of equipment and build it for several years and only change it out when they have significant improvements to make. It's actually rather costly for them to change models out, believe it or not. So they have a pretty long shelf life. But pay attention to how that rotation happens, because it does impact the value of the machinery. When it comes to showing off your piece of machinery to somebody else, be it somebody that you're trying to sell it to directly, if you're presenting it to somebody to kind of evaluate and appraise your machine, you certainly want to go through and put the best face on it, right? Like in the case of this Ford 7000 right here, got a big old flat tire. And if I was coming out to say, look at this tractor, I certainly would put some air in it first to show that it holds air, it looks good, it gives a lot more confidence in the machine than when it's sitting here like this. We should fix this because this one is ours. The other thing that you don't want to do, though, at the same time is overdo it. Anybody that's used to looking at equipment does not expect it to be shiny and new. I'm not looking to come out and see something that's all waxed. A little bit of dirt's okay. You know, generally we're able to look through that kind of stuff. So do not overclean something, and especially get out a can of spray paint and start touching things up. That kind of stuff causes people to start to question if you're hiding an underlying issue when you go too far. So a little bit of dirt from regular operation is a-okay, and kind of draw the line that you don't want to overdo it and lead somebody to think that you might be hiding something. Now, there's not a lot of people out there that change equipment out with a real regular frequency. Guys tend to buy machinery and own it and run it for several years. This isn't an industry where we see a whole lot of turn. When you talk to guys about cars and people especially that rotate cars regularly, they would tell you that there's kind of certain mileage thresholds where when you start to cross them, it causes a reduction in the value of that machine. It's usually like 30 or 40,000 miles, and then 60 or 70,000 miles. When you tip over those points, that's when you start to see the values curve off. We don't have that kind of thing so much with equipment. A lot of our things don't have hour meters, for one. It's not a really good way to be able to assess that. And generally, we're going to get a lot more concerned about the general condition of a machine, even when we have an hour meter that we can look back at. But there is one thing that does have some value on the secondary market, and that's warranty. If you're buying that machine used, having some kind of manufacturer's warranty still in place that's gonna cover any kind of issues that are still on that machine goes a long way to instilling confidence in a secondary buyer and helps hold up the value of that machine. That's one place where I would actually consider encouraging people to buy extended warranties. A lot of the base warranties on equipment, now you got a lot of long powertrain warranties, but the base warranties that cover everything aren't particularly long. And a lot of the extended warranties are priced in a way that you will have better value in that machine, say 3 or 4 years down the road if you're gonna flip it, by spending the money up front on that extended warranty, because it's giving that added confidence to a buyer. So particularly in a lot of tractors where a 1 year warranty extension is not all that expensive, might be worth the money in order to invest in that on the front side if you're planning on selling the machine not too far down the road. My final tip for keeping that value in that piece of equipment is not to over-customize your equipment. When you look at a piece of machinery, it's not bad to go through and add, say, standard features that appeal to everybody, like this front weight block here, right? If you're gonna be buying this tractor, this front weight block is worth every dollar. You'll get every one of those dollars back out again if you go sell the machine further down the road. However, there is a point that, say, adding a fifth remote out the back or four work lights up on the roll bar or some chintzy aftermarket cabs and some of that kind of stuff that does absolutely nothing for the resale value of your machine. Well, that kind of stuff might have great value to you. It probably doesn't have great value to the 10 other people that might look at to buy that machine as a secondary buyer. And so you kind of want to draw the line with how much money you invest into customizing that piece of equipment just for yourself. If you're going to put those kinds of dollars in, they should be dollars that are there for the long haul. So by following those handful of tips, you're going to be able to keep as much money in that piece of equipment as possible and have it be worth the most amount of money to a dealership like us that might be looking to trade it, or a buyer somewhere on the secondary market. Just want to keep all those things in mind. It makes a huge difference when we go to trade a piece in like that, that we know we very quickly can flip it around and find another buyer for it again. So follow those couple of guidelines. Hopefully it'll keep more money in your pocket. Hopefully, since you have more money to come back here and buy more attachments, right? Let's keep up with that. If you have any questions about your equipment, if you have parts or service needs for a machine you already have, or you're shopping for a new or used piece of equipment, give us a call at Messics. We're available at 800-222-3373. We're online at messics.com.